Hi, this is Ali Arango of LittleGuyCGI.com, and today I want to show you how to make a transforming robot inside of Blender 2.75a. So let's get started. Okay, if this is your first time in Blender, I recommend you go to File, User Preferences, then go to Input, and then choose Select with left click. Blender's default select is with right click, and this may confuse you if you're coming from Adobe or other 3D programs. Also, while you're in here, you'll probably want to put a check mark next to where it says in add-ons, where it says 3D view, 3D navigation. If you scroll down, you should put a check mark next to mesh F2, mesh inset polygons, mesh loop tools, and mesh relax. And if you scroll all the way down, to keep everything consistent as far as your controls with what I'm showing you here, you'll probably want to put a check mark next to user interface PI menus official. Okay, here we are in Blender. When you first start up Blender, this is typically the scene you'll see. Here's a cube, and you are in object mode. In Blender, to maneuver your view, you can hold your middle mouse button to maneuver like this. You can also select the navigation tab. That was one of the first things I showed you on the add-ons menu. And with the navigation tab, we can select front, back, left, right, top, bottom, front. We also have access to the view global and local view. So global is where you see everything. When we have a bunch of objects, if we select local, we'll only focus in on that one object. We also have view, perspective, and orthographic. And right here, if you look here, it says front orthographic. Orthographic is kind of like a blueprint view. So it's very useful, tends to be very useful as far as modeling. If you hold shift and hold the middle mouse button, you can pan your view. And again, we're in object mode right now, and we're gonna click here, and most of our work is gonna be done in edit mode. Okay, here in edit mode, you model your objects and you manipulate them by typically using vertices, edges, and faces, and you can select between vertices, edges, and faces right here. Okay, just so you have an idea of kind of how this is going to work, we're going to be making a robot that transforms into a jet. My plan is to show you how to model the jet, and then we're going to take pieces from the jet to basically make the robot, and then the plan is to show you how to rig this also to have the, you know, you actually go through the transformation process. Actually wanted to do this for a while, to learn how to do this and to do a tutorial on it. I think one of the coolest things in the world is a Veritech fighter from Robotech, which this isn't quite a Veritech, but it's, you know, makes me feel pleased doing this tutorial, knowing that I am even coming close to doing something like a Veritech fighter. So anyway, let's get started as far as actually doing the work of it. Okay, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to press W to bring up your specials menu. You're then going to choose subdivide smooth. You're going to look immediately over to your left, and you'll see a thing that says number of cuts. You're going to click this up to 2. Oh, and just as we go on in this, just be aware, while I do consider this a beginner tutorial, and with this being a beginner tutorial dealing with somewhat advanced stuff, I consider a beginning tutorial because I'm going to make the attempt to say every keyboard press and, you know, every shortcut. However, to do that and to not have the tutorial be 6 hours long, which, believe me, some of them have come close in the past, I'm going to have to speak relatively quickly. I'm just telling you this because I want you to know what you are getting into just as you start watching this tutorial. Okay. Okay, you want to make sure you're on face select. You want to select right here. We're going to hold the middle mouse button and turn to the side. We're going to press O, which turns on the proportional editing tool. This represents the proportional editing tool here. When you see this blue dot, kind of, you can tell that it's on. We're we're going to press G. When we press G, it allows us to see that area of influence. That area of influence allows us to manipulate more than one vertice, edge, or face at a time. So we're going to, right now, if we move it, we can see we can move in all directions. We don't want that. So we're going to press Y. So basically, I press G, and then I pressed Y, and that constrains us to this axis. We're going to take this forward about like this, and then left click to lock in. Okay, what we're going to do now is we are going to select front view. We're going to press A to deselect. We're going to press Control R. Control R puts a loop cut on your model, which you can use to separate the model. So you're going to left click once and then left click again to totally lock that in. Then what we're going to do is we're going to press O to turn off the proportional editing tool. We're then going to press Z to bring up this menu. We're going to choose wireframe. The reason why we're choosing wireframe is because we want to select faces here as well as faces that are in the back of what you're looking at. If we didn't turn on wireframe, we would grab just the front because we want to delete this geometry right here. So with wireframe on, we can grab this entire thing and get rid of it. So we're going to press O to make sure this is off. And you can see that when it's gray, it's off. We're going to go to face select. You're going to move your mouse about here. You're going to press B for box select. You're going to left click and hold, and you're going to drag a little bit past that center line. So you grab all this geometry right here. You're then going to press X to delete, and then you're going to choose faces to delete that geometry there. Okay, the reason why we got rid of that geometry there was we're going to use what's called a mirror modifier. The mirror modifier is going to take this geometry and mirror it to the other side. And what the other side means is the other side of this origin point. So it's very important that this origin point is right in the center of this geometry here. If the origin point is not, you'll have issues. So with that said, what we're going to do now is click here. We're going to go to mirror modifier and select mirror. And now we can see this mirrored geometry, you know, from this side on this side. So what you want to do now is put a check mark in clipping, and then you want to put a check mark here. And what this does is it just makes like this basically virtual geometry look like actual geometry. Okay, now that we have that done, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button just to get a slightly different view, or more 3D view. I'm going to press a Z and select solid to go back to wireframe mode. I'm going to press A to select everything. I'm going to press S to scale on the X axis, like this. And then I'm going to take my manipulator here. That's what this is. And I'm just going to push in slightly to make this thinner, like that. Okay, what you're going to do now is you're going to press A for deselect. You're going to make sure you're on face select. You're going to press C, which is paint select. And you're just going to paint all of this right here. Right click, get out of paint select just so I can manipulate the view. And that's good. We wanted all this right here. And I'm just holding the middle mouse button to rotate the view. You're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. The reason why we did that, we just created new geometry here. Now that we have that new geometry, we can press S to scale, and we can scale this geometry down. So you're going to, you know, scale it down like we did. You're going to take your manipulator and push back some. I'm going to press S to scale it down a little bit more. Left click to lock in, push it back a little bit more. Now what you're going to do is you're going to press E to extrude again, left click to lock in, and you're going to actually push this down some. And then press S to scale again. And also what we're going to do is with this selected, we're going to press the Y key. Now what that Y key did was that allowed us to, we actually just separated this cockpit windshield from the rest of here. And that'll help out later on when we're done with hard surface modeling and working that in. So if I press G and move this, you can see that this is actually a separate piece of geometry. So I'm going to right click to get this to jump right back into place. And as we're going through this, the main thing we're trying to do here is to get the general shape, and then we can refine this, you know, as we work through it, you know, later. Anyway, we're going to hold the middle mouse button. this right here, the way that's popping up like that, I don't particularly care for. So I'm going to select here, hold shift, and select here. Now I'm going to press S to scale and then Z axis 0, left click to lock in, and that just, you know, does a nice job of flattening that out. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button. With shift to pan, I'm holding the middle mouse button to turn. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to press C for paint select. We're going to select these 8 faces right here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side. We're going to take a manipulator and pull back some. We're now going to press S to scale on the Y axis 0 to flatten this out. Okay, now we're going to select right here to go to our right view. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We created new geometry that now we can pull out. We're going to pull it out about that far. Okay, actually, let's push this up to about here. Hold the middle mouse button just to take a look. Okay, what we're going to do now is I'm holding the middle mouse button to turn, holding shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm rolling the mouse wheel to zoom back. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, and create new geometry. And then we're just going to pull this back to about here. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to press and hold control and then press R. We're going to left click one time. When we put a loop cut in and we left click one time, it allows us to move that loop cut. So since we only left click one time, we're going to move this loop cut to about here. Then left click again to totally lock it in. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to make sure we're on face select. We're going to select right here. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to hold shift to select the second panel here. See how there's a slight bend in here? We're going to press S to scale on the X axis 0, then left click to lock in to flatten that out. We're going to press E to create new geometry, left click to lock in, and we're going to take our manipulator and we're going to pull out to about here. I'm going to actually push back in a little. So about here. Then we're going to do is press a S to scale on the Z axis like this. Left click to lock in. We're then going to press a S to scale on the Y axis like this. Then left click to lock in. Okay, now we're going to take our manipulator and we're going to push up about like there. We're now going to press Control R to put a loop cut in right here. Left click one time. And then you're going to pull to the side about to here. And then left click again to lock in. Okay, you're going to press A to deselect. With edge select on, you're going to select right here. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel in. I'm going to hold shift to select the second edge. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom back. I'm going to push straight out about like that there. I'm going to select here, hold shift, zoom in, hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to hold shift and select here, pull this straight back like that. I'm going to push in a little bit like this. I'm holding the middle mouse button just to take a look, see how everything's looking. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to swivel the view up. I'm going to select here, hold shift, and select here. I'm going to pull this back a little bit. I'm now going to go to face select. I'm going to select here, hold shift, select here, 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 as well as here and here. I'm rolling the mouse wheel to zoom back. I'm holding the middle mouse button to pan. Now I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We just created new geometry, so now we can just pull this straight out. I'm holding the middle mouse button to rotate the view. We need to pull this out a little bit further. Now we're going to press S to scale on the X axis 0, and then left click to lock in. We did that just to flatten that edge out right there. Okay, now we're going to press S to scale on the Y axis. This. Let's hold the middle mouse button to take a look. rolling the mouse wheel to zoom back. I'm going to take the manipulator and pull back like that. Holding shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Okay, we're actually going to push this forward a little like that. We got a little bit of strangeness right here, so we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to press C for paint select. We're going to select all of this right here. I'm going to right click to get out. We're going to press S to scale and a Z axis 0 just to flatten that out. Left click to lock in. We're going to go to the top. We're going to select here, hold shift, select here, 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 here. You could also have done that with paint select. Just chose to select it by holding shift that time. You're going to press S to scale and the Z axis 0 and then left click to lock in. And now we just have flattened areas. I prefer to just have everything in control. That's why I flattened out, you know, the top of this and the bottom of that wing there. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A for deselect. We're going to select here, hold shift and select here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom in and hold the middle mouse button to turn. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in and create new geometry. We're going to pull out to about here. We're going to press S to scale on the Y axis. That just holding the middle mouse button to take a look. I'm gonna pull it out a little bit wider there, and I press S to scale on the Y axis here. Left click to lock in. Okay, what we're gonna do now is press A to deselect. We're gonna press Control R to put a loop cut here. You can see a preview right there. We're gonna left click once, that allows us to drag this. We're going to move this to the side to about here. Left click to lock in. The second time, which is totally locked in. Okay, now we're going to go to face select. We're going to select here. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button just to maneuver to view. We're going to pull straight up. We're going to press S to scale on the Y axis like this. Left click to lock in. We're going to pull straight back like that. We're going to hold the middle mouse button just to maneuver to view. We're going to pull to the side like that. I'm just taking a look again. Okay, now we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to make sure we're still on face select. We're going to select right here. We're going to press E to extrude. Left click to lock in. Hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view. We're going to pull out to about here. We're going to press S to scale on the Y axis, like this. Hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view, or turn the view, pull back about like that. I'm going to press S to scale on the X axis 0, left click to lock in, hold the middle mouse button just to look at the view. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to make sure we're on face select. Roll the mouse wheel just to zoom in. I'm holding shift and selecting zoom. Sometimes the manipulator will get in your way. A lot of times you'll see me like roll the mouse, and I roll the mouse just to get the manipulator out of the way. If you press, control space, you can take away the manipulator. And then press control space, you can bring it back. But a lot of times if you just maneuver your view or zoom in, you know, you'll be able to maneuver the manipulator and, you know, get it out of the way enough so that you can select the face or edge that you're, or vertice that you're trying to get to. Okay, now what you're going to do is I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and turn to the side. I'm going to push this up here. I'm now going to press S to scale on the Y axis 0 and then left click to lock in and push this up a little bit more like that. I'm going to press A to deselect. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button. I'm going to roll the mouse to zoom in. Hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Hold the middle mouse button to change the view again. I'm going to press control R. I'm going to left click to lock in. I'm going to move this to the side slightly. I'm going to left click again, totally lock in. I'm going to go to face select. I'm going to press C for paint select. I'm going to select all of these faces here. Okay, the reason why we put this loop cut here was so that we can, you know, select these faces and just push back like this. I'm going to press A to deselect. hold the middle mouse button just to look here. I'm gonna actually select here, hold shift, select here. I'm gonna press S to scale and the Y axis 0. Left click to lock in. We're now going to press A to deselect. We're on face select, so we're gonna press C for paint select. We're gonna select all right here. We're gonna right click to get out of paint select. We're gonna press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We just created new geometry. We're gonna press S to scale that new geometry down like this. I'm gonna take our manipulator and push in a little bit. Now we're gonna press W to bring up our specials menu. We're gonna go to loop tools. Remember I showed you those add-ons in the beginning? One of those add-ons was loop tools, and you're just gonna go, if you put a check mark next to loop tools, you'll see this you know option to do this. If you didn't, you won't. When I select circle, it's just very easy to make a circular shape using loop tools. However, you can just manually also take your vertices and just, you know, manually form a circular, you know, shape with them. Okay, so now we're going to press, well, slightly, very slightly, we'll press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We'll pull this out about like that. Then we'll press E to extrude again, left click to lock in, about like that. Pushing this a little bit, then we're going to press S to scale down some. When you scale down some, a lot of times you'll see your circular shape kind of like spreading to the side. That happens, just take your manipulator and just push in some like that. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We created new geometry, lets us scale like this. Same thing again, if it starts going, you know, horizontal as you're scaling down, just take your manipulator and push in. And now you're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, and just push in some like this. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in again, like that. And maybe we'll push in a little bit more. And then we'll press A to deselect. Okay, what we're going to do now is roll the mouse wheel to zoom back, hold the middle mouse button to turn, hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. We're going to make sure we're on face select. We're going to select here, hold shift and select here, 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 and here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn. We're going to press shift D, left click to lock in. Now when we press shift D, we created new geometry, but the new geometry that we created is not attached to the old geometry, if that makes sense to you. Okay, so with that done, we're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We're going to pull this straight out to the side, about like this. And then we're going to press S to scale on the X axis 0, left click to lock in. And then we obviously have this geometry pushing in this geometry, so we're going to press S to scale on the Y axis like this. And then left click to lock in. Holding the middle mouse button to turn to the side to take a look. Okay, now we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to select right here, roll the mouse wheel to zoom in, hold shift and middle mouse button to pan, pull to the side, a little like that. Okay, we'll press A to deselect. We're going to go to edge select, select here, hold shift. Roll the mouse wheel to zoom in, hold shift again, we'll pull this back some like this. Roll the mouse wheel to zoom out. Okay, we're going to go to face select, we're going to select here, we're going to hold shift and select here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to change the view. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'm going to pull this new geometry out like this. I'm going to press S to scale and the Z axis like this. I'm going to press S to scale on the Y axis like this. Pull this back some like that. Then I'm going to press S to scale on the X axis 0 to flatten that out. Push this in like that, not too much. Just taking a look. Okay, now we have our basic shape, so we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to hold the middle mouse button and turn to the side. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to press Control R, left click to put that loop cut in. I left click one time, so that allows us to be able to move this. Left click again. See how it's not quite straight, so we're going to press S to scale and the X axis 0 to lock in. I press S to scale and the X axis 0 to straighten that line out, and hopefully you guys can see how useful it is using S to scale and the Z, X, or Y axis to straighten out lines, particularly when you're dealing with vehicles or modeling vehicles. Okay, I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. Roll in again. I'm going to hold the press the face select. I'm going to select right here. I'm going to press E to extrude. Left click to lock in. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom back. Pull this back here. I'm going to press S to scale in the X axis like this. And then S to scale in the Z axis. And you can see our preview lines, you know, popping up. Very nice that Blender has them. S to scale in the X axis. Because sometimes you know, even as you're working, you'll forget, but the preview lines are very useful. Anyway, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to press Control R to put a loop cut in. I'm going to left click one time because I only left clicked one time, I can move this loop cut. I'm going to left click again to totally lock in. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to go to face select. I'm going to select right here. I'm going to press E to extrude. Left click to lock in. I'm going to pull out this way. And then I'm going to press S to scale on the X axis. Like that. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to hold shift and select this. Let go of shift. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. Hold shift again. Then I'm going to press S to scale on the Z axis. Like that. Roll the mouse wheel out to take a look. Press A to deselect. Okay, what we're going to do now is thin these wings out some. So I'm going to zoom the mouse wheel in. I'm going to hold shift and select here. Here, all of these faces here. And what we're going to do is press S to scale and the Z axis. That left click to lock in, hold the middle mouse button to turn to the back, select here as well as here. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn, you know, manipulate the view. We'll hold shift and select here as well. Now we're going to press S to scale on the Z axis. Like that, hold the middle mouse button. We're going to press A to deselect. We're going to select here, hold shift, select here, hold the middle mouse button, turn to the back. When I hold the middle mouse button, I'm letting go of shift, by the way. Now I'm holding shift again. I'm selecting here. I've rolled the mouse wheel back. Now I'm going to press S to scale on the Z axis yet again. Left click to lock in. Okay, here's an interesting situation. I want to make these thinner, right? I'm going to press A to deselect. So if I select these, watch what happens. If I press S to scale on the X axis, you see that? How it's changing the shape, which I don't want. So what do you do to thin this down like the other, you know, wing areas? I'm going to right click to get out of that. So what you would do in this situation, what I would do, there's always multiple ways to do things, is you're going to press A to deselect. You're going to go to one edge. You'll select this edge here. And then what you'll do is just actually push that edge in. Select the other edge, you know, push the edge in. And, you know, this way you can get your thinness of the wing that you're going for, but not have to worry about the angle of the wing actually changing. To hold the middle mouse button to look around. Sometimes it's advantageous over scaling it. This one we probably could have scaled, just did S to scale on the Z axis, but I figured out what the heck. Holding the mouse button to turn. I'm gonna roll the mouse wheel to zoom in. We have like a little bit of weirdness right here, so I'm going to select here. See that overlapping stuff right there? So we'll just pull that down, and that kind of fixes that. And now, one thing to remember is, like, we're going to eventually put a subdivision surface on here. So when we put that subdivision surface on, a lot is maybe not a lot. It'll change some. Then we'll have to use some hard surface modeling techniques to get it the way we want it to look. It being our transformable plane. Hold the middle mouse button. We're gonna go to face select. We're gonna select here. Hold shift. I just rolled the mouse, but I didn't hold shift just yet. Now I'm holding shift. We're gonna press S to scale on the Z axis here. And this is changing the angle a little bit by doing that, but that's not too bad. Let's select here, press S to scale on the Z axis. Yeah, I'm fine with it, changing there. Okay, so now we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to go to edge select and hold the middle mouse button to turn. We're going to select right here, hold shift, select right here, hold the middle mouse button to turn to view. And we're just pulling this up so that this geometry is kind of, in line with that geometry there. This will probably make it go down slightly. Hold them the mouse button just to take a look. Okay, so what we're going to do now is start working on our robot, and we're going to take pieces of the plane to form the robot. And then what we'll probably do, the way I'm thinking of it now, is once we have the robot, we'll come back to the plane, and then once we have the full plane model complete along with the additional robot parts and the robot complete, then we'll work on having the plane turn into the robot or animate into the robot. Okay, what we're going to do now is start separating the pieces out that we need to form the robot. This is already a separate piece right here, and since it's a separate piece, I'm going to press L to select right here, and for now I'm going to press H just to hide that geometry. Okay, what we're going to do now is zoom in, hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. We are going to select here, there, here, here, and here. Just going to make sure I'm right. Yeah, I'm trying to imagine how I want this thing to look in robot form. So I'm just holding the middle mouse button to turn. We're just selecting that whole loop right there. I wasn't sure if I held, if you hold Alt and select a loop, typically Blender will select the entire loop. I just did it manually because I wasn't sure if it would. So anyway, what we're going to do now is we're going to split this edge right here. Now, when you use the technique that we're about to use, if you have your mouse this way, the edge will be split with you holding onto this geometry. If you have your mouse here, the edge will be split with your mouse holding onto this side of the geometry. So move your mouse here. You're going to press V and then left click to lock in. Now what that V did, that is the rip key. So it just, rip shortcut. So it just separated this from this part of the geometry from this part. And the way that we can tell that it separated is we'll press A to deselect. Then we're going to press L. And now you can see it just selected this whole part because it's technically separate now from over there. So we'll, this is also a piece that we separated. So we'll hover our mouse here and press L. And then what we're going to do is press H to hide that geometry there. Okay, what we're going to do now is I'm going to hold the middle mouse button, rotate, and we're going to go to face select. We're going to select here, hold shift and select here, here, and here. And we are going to press Y to separate this geometry. And I'm going to press A to deselect. So Y is when you, like in the beginning, we separated the cockpit glass part by using Y. So V rips, but it typically rips a line. And then Y is when you like if we selected this and press Y, we could just lift this panel right up. And to check it, we'll hover here and press L, and we can see now that that's separate, so we're going to press H to hide that geometry. Okay, so we have the pieces, I think, to, that we need separated. So we'll press Alt H to unhide everything. We're gonna click here, go back to object mode. I'm gonna zoom back. See this right here? These are layer panels. They're more for organization than like if you're used to Photoshop or GIMP. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna press Shift D to duplicate this object. So I pulled to the side, I didn't left click or push anything. I'm gonna right click, which makes it jump right back. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press M, and this brings up our Move to Layer panel. And then I'm just gonna move this to here. And just so, you know, we have something to go back to as we, you know, manipulate this here. So with that done, we'll select here and see, you can see there's the layer right there. But since we are selected on this layer, we can see this right here. Anyway, we're gonna click here and go back into edit mode now. Okay, what we're gonna do now is we're going to press A to deselect. We're gonna hover here and press L. We're gonna pull these out to the side like this. We're gonna press H to hide them. We're going to press A to select everything, A to deselect everything, just to make sure nothing's selected. We're gonna hover L, hover here and press L, press L here. Now we're gonna select right view. We're going to put our mouse about here, I believe. Okay, and yes, we do want the 3D cursor there. We're also gonna hover here and press L. Now what we're gonna do is click here and change this pivot point from Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point, to the 3D cursor, which means that everything will rotate or pivot off of this 3D cursor, which is exactly what we want. So now we're gonna press R to rotate on the X axis 90, and then left click to lock in. Okay, now we're gonna press A to deselect. We're gonna put our mouse right here, you know, just hovering over this other object. We're gonna press L to select all of that. We're gonna right click right here. We're going to press R to rotate on the X axis negative 90, and then left click to lock in. Okay, I'm gonna press A to deselect. I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side. I'm gonna roll the mouse wheel to zoom back, hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to press Alt H to bring these objects back. I'm gonna press R to rotate on the X axis 90, and then left click to lock in. Okay, I'm now going to change the pivot point from the 3D cursor back to Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point. Okay, and with these two pieces still selected, we're gonna press R to rotate on the Y axis, negative 90, then left click to lock in, and then we'll just push these in to about here. I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side. We'll take the manipulator and push forward slightly like that, so these aren't intersecting with the wings there. Okay, now we'll take our manipulator and push these up some. I'm gonna select front view about like that. Okay, what we're gonna do now is press A to deselect. We're gonna make sure we're still on face select, and we are. I'm holding the middle mouse button to turn to the side, rolling the mouse wheel to zoom in, holding Shift. So with this geometry here selected, I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side. I'm gonna press Shift D, left click to lock in. We just created brand new geometry that's not connected to that geometry. And then we're gonna press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We created new geometry on top of the new geometry that we just created, and that we're just gonna pull out to the side here like this. Now we're gonna press S to scale on the Z axis like this. Left click to lock in. Okay, now what we're gonna do is press A to deselect. We're gonna go to edge select. We're gonna zoom in, hold the middle mouse button, turn to the side. We're gonna select here and select here. I'm holding Shift to select both of those edges. We're going to pull out to the side just slightly, and then very slightly push down about like that. Just roll the mouse wheel to take a look. Press A to deselect. And one thing that I let go through my mind when I'm working on a robot or a mech is that duplication tends to work fairly well while, you know, working on robots and mechs. Anyway, I'm gonna hold L here, or hover L, that, hover the mouse wheel here, press L, then I'm going to press S to scale on the Y axis, like this, to thin this out. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button at turn to look back this way. Hold the middle mouse button at look. I'm going to push this forward some like that. I'm going to go to face select. Select here, hold shift, and select here. Okay, with those faces selected, I'm going to press shift D. Left click to lock in. Rolling the mouse wheel to zoom in, holding the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to pull up just slightly. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'm going to pull straight up like this. About to there. I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hover my mouse wheel here, press L, pull this out somewhat like this. Hold the middle mouse button, push this forward, then up some like this. Hold the middle mouse button and take a look. Okay, now we're going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom back. I'm going to right click right here to put the 3D cursor right there. Okay, now we're going to press shift A. We're going to bring in a circle from our mesh menu, which you can see right there. I'm going to left click to select circle. I'm going to look to the left. You see this add circle menu where it says vertices. And by some chance you don't see this, hit the T key and it should pop up. Change this 32 to 12, then left click to lock in. I'm going to zoom in here. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Zoom in a little bit more. You're going to go to vertices select. You're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. Drag this straight up about there. You're going to go to edge select. You're going to hold shift, hold art, alt, and select this other edge here. You're then going to click here to the pivot point option, change it from Blender's default pivot point to the medium point to individual origins. You're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. You're going to press S to scale like this. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button. The reason why I had you change the individual origins was just so that when you scaled, this actually scaled straight out over here instead of normally it would like kind of push down a little bit. And then with both of these edges selected, what you can do now is press Control E. This brings up our edges menu, and then you can choose bridge edge loops, and then bridge edge loops fills in all this geometry here, which is very cool. This shading looks kind of strange here because the normals are most likely not right, so we're going to press L to select this entire thing, press Control N to recalculate the normals, and now you can see the shading looks, you know, correct again. Okay, what you're going to do now is press shift D, left click to lock in, hold the middle mouse button, turn the view slightly, I'm going to pull straight up here like that. Okay, now what you're going to do is press A to deselect. You're going to hold alt, select here, because we held alt, we select the entire edge loop. You're going to press shift D to duplicate that geometry, left click to lock in. You're going to press S to scale just slightly. I'll rotate the view by holding the mouse button so you can see a little bit better. And then you are going to press F to fill. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button so you can see this top manipulator a little bit better. You're going to pull this up some. Hold the middle mouse button here. And not that high. Push it down about there. You're going to press E to extrude. Left click to lock in. Create new geometry. Then you're just going to push down something like that. Just like this. And we got a face select, like this top face, and push this down a little. I'm going to hover my mouse over this piece right here, press L, then press Control N, which recalculates the normals. Okay, the reason why we did this was so that we can just grab whenever we need like a kind of joint piece of machinery, we can just use this fairly quickly. So we're going to press Z to go to wireframe. I'm going to hold Control, hold the right mouse button. That lets me draw a loop select. I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in, and then move this piece of geometry out here. I'm going to click here and change this pivot point from the individual origins back to Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point. I'm going to press Z and then go back to solid view. Okay, now I'm going to roll the mouse wheel back. I'm going to push this new geometry over here. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'll zoom in, then I'll push this up some like this. I'm going to press R to rotate on the x-axis 90, and then left click to lock in. I'm going to press S to scale. And I'm just moving them, taking the manipulator and moving this kind of into place here. Press S to scale a little bit more. And for now, we'll leave that like that. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. I'm going to hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side slightly. We're going to make sure we're on face select. We're going to select right here. We're going to press Shift D to duplicate. Left click to lock in. Holding the middle mouse button to turn slightly. I'm going to press E to extrude. Left click to lock in. Take the manipulator and pull to the side. Yes, I am going very fast because we still have a lot to cover. Okay, what we're going to do now is press Control R to put a loop cut in. We want our preview to be going vertical, so we're going to left click once. Because we left clicked it once, we can move it a little bit. We move it inward a little bit towards the main part of the body. We're going to left click again to totally lock in. We're going to press Control R to put another loop cut in. We clicked one time, which means we can move this loop cut. We're going to move it up, something like that. Left click again to totally lock it in. We're going to go to face select, select this face, and pull up like this. Now pull out some like that. I guess we'll pull up a little bit more, something like that. Hold the middle mouse button just to take a look. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to right click right here. We're going to press Shift A. We're going to bring in a UV sphere. You're going to look over to your left where you see this Add UV Sphere menu. You're going to change your segments to 8. You're going to change your rings to 8. We're going to zoom in here. Hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Make sure we're on face select. We're going to select. We're going to press A to deselect. We're going to press C to paint select all of this right here. We're going to right click. We're going to press S to scale and the Z axis 0 to flatten out that geometry. We're going to hold the middle mouse button. We're going to press A to deselect. Press C for paint select. Same thing here. Right click to get out of paint select. S to scale and the Z axis 0. Flatten out that area. Okay, now you're going to press A to deselect. You're going to press C for paint select. Select that area right there. Right click to get out of paint select. Hold the middle mouse button to turn view. I'm going to press E to extrude to create new geometry. Left click to lock in. Push up some there. Hold the mouse button to change the view. Press A to deselect. Press C for paint select. Select right here. Right click to get out of paint select. E to extrude to create new geometry. Left click to lock in. Hold the mouse button to change the view. Push straight down like that. Press A to deselect. I'm going to press A to select everything just so that I know when I press A again, nothing is selected. We're going to hold Alt and select here, then hold Alt and select here. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, press S to scale in just a little bit, then left click to lock in. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hover my mouse here, press L to select everything. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis, negative 90, left click to lock in. Push over here, roll the mouse wheel to zoom back, hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Down a little bit here like that. Press S to scale. Just taking a manipulator to, you know, get this into place for some joints for the legs. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. The reason why we tend to make objects out here instead of close together is we have this clipping on here, and if you make an object too close, you can always turn off clipping, but they will get stuck together here, so I just tend to make them out here. Anyway, I'm going to press Shift A, or bring them in out here. Anyway, I'm going to select cube. I am going to press W, choose subdivide smooth one time. I'm going to press S to scale on the Y axis, like this. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and turn to the side. I'm going to press C, select these faces here. I'm going to press S to scale and the Z axis 0, left click to lock in. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, S to scale. Then I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. Holding the middle mouse button a turn, I'm going to take the manipulator and push down some. Then I'm going to press X to bring up a delete menu and choose faces to delete those faces. I'm going to select here, hold shift, select there, select here, select here. I'm going to press X to bring up our delete menu, and choose delete. Now I'm going to press, so I'm going to go to vertices, select here, hold shift, and select, missed it. Again, let's zoom in, see better. I just grab the vertice here and the vertice there. I'm going to take the manipulator and pull straight up, holding the middle mouse button at turn. Okay, I'm going to roll the mouse wheel back. I'm going to hover over this object, press L. I'm going to pull this to the side. I'm going to press Shift D to duplicate here. I'm going to push this in here. I'm going to press S to scale on the X axis like this. Be careful about crossing that center line. Press S to scale on the X axis even more. I held the middle mouse button to turn to the side. Now you want to press S to scale on the Y axis like this. And now you're going to press R to rotate on the X axis like this. I'm going to zoom in, I'm going to go to edge select, I'm going to press A to deselect, I'm going to hold alt and select this edge right here, I'm going to press S to scale. Zooming back to take a look. Okay, I am going to hover over here, press L, press Shift D, left click to lock in, I'm going to drag this up. Side like this. Okay, I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. I'm going to press S to scale. Like that. I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hover here and press L. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. Pull this out to the side a little bit. I'm going to press S to scale. Push this down some. I'm going to press A to deselect. Okay, now I'm going to hover here. I'm going to press L. Push this up just a little bit. I'm going to press Shift D. Left click to lock in. Push straight down. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis a little. I'm going to press R to rotate on the X axis 180. Left click to lock in. Push this to the side some. Push this forward some. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis. Hold the mouse button to turn to the side. I'm going to press R to rotate on the X axis. Okay, I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in. I'm going to press S to scale. R to rotate on the X axis. Press R to rotate on the Y axis. Press S to scale on the Z axis lately. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to press Z to go to wireframe. I'm going to hold the control button, hold the right mouse button, do a lasso select around here. I'm going to press Shift D. Left click to lock in. I'm going to press Z to go back to solid mode. I am going to press R to rotate on the Y axis 90. Left click to lock in. Push this over here. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. Zoom in so we can see better. So that's the scale. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis as for now. I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in. Push this down like this. R to rotate on the Y axis. Press S to scale. Then S to scale on the X axis. Is this going to x-axis a little bit more, like so. Okay, so what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button, change the view, hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan, roll the mouse wheel in to zoom in, hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan again, roll the mouse wheel to zoom in again. Going to face select, I'm going to hold alt, select right here. I'm going to press X to bring up our delete menu, choose faces to delete. I'm going to select the face right here. I'm going to press Control L. Because when you select a piece of an object, and then if you press Control L, it'll select the rest of that separate object. So I'm going to press X to bring up our delete menu, choose faces to delete. I'm going to go to edge select, hold alt, and select this edge right here. I'm going to press S to scale. I'm going to press S to scale on the Y axis here. I'm going to press S to scale on the Z axis 0 to flatten that out. Down a little bit more. I'm going to press Control F. This brings up our faces menu. I'm going to choose grid fill. If grid fill by some chance, you know, gives you have some kind of issue with, you can just manually take the vertices and fill this area in. You could either, you know, fill it in by selecting a vertice here, duplicating it, putting it there, you know, there, and so forth, or you could just select the entire ring and press F and it will do that. But hopefully grid fill works out for you. Anyway, I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to press Control R to put a loop cut right here. I'm going to left click to lock in. I guess I pressed twice there. I'm going to press Control R. There's my preview line. Left click once, left click twice to lock in twice. Or lock in, period. I'm going to press A to deselect. Okay, now we're going to press Control, hold Control, press R, left click to lock in, left click again to totally lock in. Then we're going to go to face, select here, hold shift, select here. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, push this out like this, press S to scale and then Z axis like this. Just push that down some. I'm going to press S to scale and the Y axis 0. Left click to lock in. Let's back some. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom in. I'm going to press Control R to put one loop cut there. I'm going to roll the mouse one time to put two. I'm going to left click once to lock in, left click again to totally lock in. I'm going to go to face select. I'm going to hold alt. I'm going to select right here. Because I was holding alt, it allowed me to select that whole edge. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, press S to scale. Okay, now I'm going to press A. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan down. With face select still on, we're going to select here, hold shift, select here, hold the middle mouse button while letting go of shift, hold shift again, select here, still holding shift. Deselect that one. So when I was holding shift, if you have one thing selected and you select another thing, it'll deselect. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to press shift D, left click to lock in. Then I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. Then I'm going to press Alt S. That, then left click to lock in. Okay, what we're about to do now is we're going to press A to deselect. We want to move this cursor to the center of our scene. So we're going to press Shift C to do that. Now we're going to click here, go into object mode, and we're going to press Shift A. This brings up our add to menu, our add to mesh menu. Then we're going to go and bring in a cube. We're then going to select this button right here, which says view global slash local. Currently we're in global mode. We're about to go into local mode, and that'll allow us just to focus on this one cube here that we're working on. So we'll click here. Okay, I'm gonna roll the mouse wheel back, the zoom back. I'm gonna press tab and then go into the edit mode for the cube. I'm gonna press W and choose subdivide smooth. I'm going to go to the number of cuts. I'm gonna take this up to 2 cuts. Okay, and what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to press O to turn on our proportional editing tool. You're going to go to edge select. You're going to select right here. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom back, holding the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to get rid of this grid floor. I'm going to press N, then select display, then select grid floor. You can always come back to here and put a check mark back in there if you want that grid floor back on. Press N to take that properties menu away. I'm going to press G. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to make the area of influence a little bit smaller. I'm going to pull this down about like that. Take it up just slightly. Okay, what we're going to do now is we are going to select front view, and we want to be in front orthographic view. So now we're going to press Control R. We're going to left click to lock in, left click again to totally lock in. We're going to press O to turn off the proportional editing tool. We're going to press Z to go to wireframe. We're going to press A to deselect, B for box select. We're going to select all of this geometry right here. We're going to press X to bring up our delete menu, choose faces to delete those faces. And we're going to click here and add a mirror modifier to this mesh. We're going to select clip, and then we're going to select faces, then press Z, and then solid. We're also going to click this right here. See that weirdness right there? We select everything, pulled, and it fixes itself, kind of. Or actually not kind of, it actually fixes itself. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to select here, hold shift, select here, hold the middle mouse button, turn to the side. We're going to press E to create new geometry, E for extrude to create new geometry, left click to lock in. We're going to press S to scale down. We're going to pull this in a little. We're then going to press A to deselect. We're going to hold Alt, select right here. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. We're going to push this geometry out some, just like that. Okay, we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to make sure we're on face select. We're going to select right here. We're going to press S to scale this up some. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, press S to scale. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and turn to the side. We're going to press W to bring up our specials menu. We're going to choose subdivide. Then we're going to press W to bring our specials menu back up. Go to loop tools and select circle. Okay, now we're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, pull out a little, press S to scale. Put a little bit more. Now we're going to press A to deselect. We're going to press Control R to put a loop cut right here, left click to lock in. I'm going to press S to scale. Just trying to get a little bit more, round shape there. Okay, I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and turn here. I'm going to select face select. I'm going to select here, while holding shift. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'm going to press S to scale. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom in. Holding shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. Push down slightly. Press S to scale. So I'm going to press E to extrude again, left click to lock in, then I'm going to press S to scale some more. Then I'm going to press, I'm going to press E to extrude and just let it come out, you know, following the angle that it's on. I'll push this in some. Okay, now what we're going to do is we are going to go to our mirror modifier, select the X button to take off the mirror modifier. We're going to click here, go back in object mode, select view global local. You can see we're in local now. We're going to select here to go back to global. Now what we're going to do is, with this still selected, we're going to hold shift, select this right here. Then we're going to press control J. And basically what happened was is this got a mirror modifier look to it again, because what we just pressed control J when we joined it to this mesh had a mirror modifier on it, so this piece adopted that mirror modifier, and that's why, you know, it's looks full again, or, you know, not just a half again. So we're going to click edit to go into here. I'm going to press L to select this head. I'm going to pull this back, push this up. I'm going to hold shift the middle mouse button to pan, roll the mouse wheel to zoom in. I'm going to press S to scale. You can see it stretches it out when I scale it. That's fine. You just push in again like that. Scale a little bit more. Zoom in back just to take a look. Press A to deselect. Okay, now we're going to go back to edit mode. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to select one face here. Then I'm going to press Shift-S to bring up our Snap Tool menu. I'm going to choose a cursor to select it to bring the cursor right here. Okay, what we're going to do is press Shift-A to bring up our Mesh Add To menu. We're going to select a cube. We're going to press S to scale. Here. Okay, we're going to press S to scale on the x-axis. And what we're going to do is we're going to press Control R to put a loop cut in. We're going to roll once, then twice, then we're going to left click to lock in, left click again to totally lock in. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. We're going to press L to select this whole object. We're going to press S to scale on the Z axis, like this. Left click to lock in. Okay, we're going to press S to scale on the Y axis a little. We're going to press Control R. We're going to put one loop cut in. I just left click one time so we can move this. I'm going to push this back some. Then I'm going to left click again to totally lock it in. Okay, now we're going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hover my mouse here, press L. Taking a look, I'm going to press S to scale on the Y axis just a little. If this gets in our way, we can press Shift H and everything will disappear but what we have selected. So I'm going to select these back faces here, pull back just a little. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and turn to the front. I'm going to select these faces here. I'm going to change our pivot point from Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point, to individual origins. I'm then going to press Alt E to bring up our extrude menu. I'm going to choose individual faces. I'm going to left click to lock in. Then I'm going to right click just so that those faces didn't move. Now I'm going to push forward a little here. Now I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in. Push them forward like that. Then I'm going to press S to scale on the x-axis the other direction. Okay, now I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. This. Press Shift D, left click to lock in. And press E to extrude. Push straight forward, and then Shift D, straight forward, and E to extrude like that. I'm going to It's like right here, I'm going to press Shift D, move this out to here. I'm going to go to Edge Select. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button and turn this way. I'm going to select this edge right here. With that edge selected, I'm going to pull in some. I'm going to select gonna press Z, go to wireframe. I'm gonna select all of this right here, all this geometry. I'm gonna push this in something like that. I'm gonna press A to deselect, Z change this back to solid. I'm gonna select this face and push this up some. I'm gonna press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'm gonna hold the middle mouse button so you can get a better view. Push this over. I'm gonna hover here and press L. I'm gonna move this a little bit closer, and I'm going to press Shift D again, or not Shift D, yeah, Shift D, and S to scale on the x-axis, S to scale on the z-axis, okay, now I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hold Alt and press H to bring back our other geometry. I'm going to press A to deselect, press Z to go to wireframe. I'm going to hold the control button down, hold the right mouse button down, and select this right here. I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in, pull this out, push this down, press Z, go back to solid view, roll the mouse wheel to zoom in, hold Shift and middle mouse button to pan, pull this forward. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis, 90. Nope, it's on individual origins. So I'm going to click here, change this back to the medium point, which Blender's default medium point. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis, 90. Left click to lock in. I'm going to press S to scale. Bring this in. Nope. Just hold the manipulator. I mean, using the manipulator to push this into place. Pull this up. There we go. Press S to scale. Holding Shift the middle mouse button to pan. Rolling the mouse wheel to zoom in. I'm going to press S to scale on the Y axis. Then I'm going to press Shift D. Left click to lock in. Shift D, oop, no Shift S, it's Shift D, left click to log in, use manipulator, pull to the side, Shift D, left click to log in, now I'm going to hover here and press L, 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 now I'm going to press Shift D, left click to log in, push straight forward with the manipulator. Push down a little. Press S to scale to make these a little bit bigger. And hit Control Z. Control Z again. I can click here, turn on individual origins, and now scale them so it'll get bigger and they won't actually, you know, move to the side like they just did. I'll press Shift D, left click to lock in, push these straight forward like that. And now we still have individual origins on, so I'll press S to scale down some. Hold the middle mouse button just to take a look. I'm going to press A to deselect. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to click here and change this pivot point from the individual origins back to Blender's default pivot point, which is the medium point. I'm going to zoom my mouse in here. I'm going to hover here and press L to select that object. Press L here, then L there. I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in, push this here. I'm going to press R to rotate on the Z axis, 90. Left click to lock in, pull this over here. I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in, put this here. Okay, what we're going to do now is press A to deselect. We're going to press Z to go to wireframe. We're going to hold control, hold the right mouse button, draw a lasso select right here. Holding the mouse button to turn, I'm going to press Z to go back to solid mode. I'm going to press R to rotate on the X axis. Take the manipulator and push this back. I'm just holding the mouse button to C. Push this down a little, out a little. Press R to rotate on the X axis. Rolling back to take a look. Press R to rotate on the Y axis. Again. Now we'll press A to deselect, we'll press Z, go to wireframe, we'll hold control, hold the right mouse button, select right here, press Shift D, left click to lock in, press Z, go back to solid view, take the manipulator and push this over, push this down. We'll press R to rotate on the Y axis, 90, left click to lock in, manipulator and just push this into place. You can see how you gotta maneuver your view because a lot of times things will look like they're one way in one view, but in the other view, so we'll press R to rotate on the Z axis. Press S to scale. Rolling the mouse wheel back just to take a look. Okay, and don't be too concerned about proportions right now because we can always adjust that later. We're going to hover here. I'm going to press A to select everything, A to make sure that absolutely nothing is selected. We're going to press L to select right here. We're going to pull this out a little, zoom in. I'm going to hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. We're going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, press Alt S, pull to make this have some thickness to it, left click to lock in, press A to deselect. Okay, now we're gonna hold Alt and select right here. Let me press A to deselect, A to select everything, and again to make sure that absolutely nothing is selected. I'm gonna go to edge select, hold Alt and let me select that whole edge loop. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, press S to scale in. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, as the scale wins some more. So okay, now I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in, lift this up some. I'm going to press F for fill. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'm going to pull this up, pull this back some. I'm going to hover over that piece and press Control N to recalculate the normals. I'm going to press S to scale on the Z axis. This back, so I'm going to press R to rotate on the X axis. I'm going to press S to scale on the Z axis. Take a look. Okay, now we're going to have some hard surface modeling to do. So, what we're going to do is press A to select everything, then we're going to press Control 2. What that did was automatically put a subdivision surface on everything. We're gonna press Z and then select Shade Smooth. Okay, and as you can see that when you put a subdivision surface onto something that is supposed to be hard, it softens it up, so you know you have a decent amount of changes to deal with. The good thing is a lot of our materials are separated from each other, like they're actual separate objects. So that should make it a little bit easier to go through this process. Okay, so what we're going to do is go through here and pick and choose what we want to be hard. So we're going to go for the hardest things right now. So we're going to go to face select here. I'm going to hold shift, hold alt. Oops, I'm going to press A to deselect first. I'm going to hold shift, hold alt. And I'm going to select right here. I am going to hover here and press L. Because these gears, we definitely want them to be hard. Same thing with these right here. So we'll press L. Here's more gears here. We want these to be hard as well. I'm just hovering and pressing L. By the way, if you press Shift L, you will deselect what you're hovering over, which is nice to know about. I'm going to press Z, go to wireframe, because we want this whole hand to be hard. I'm going to hold Shift and the middle mouse button to pan down. I'm going to press Z, go back to solid view. Okay, we're going to want these as well, so we'll, whoops. And those were connected like that. I'm going to click here. Okay, so we'll press, just making sure that other stuff's still selected. C for paint selected. We'll select all this right here. Hold the middle mouse button to rotate. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to get rid of that piece right there. And I'm going to right click to get out of paint select. Okay, so what we're going to do is roll the mouse wheel back. You have these different pieces selected. These aren't all the pieces, but we can start with them. What we're going to do is we're going to put mean creases on here. So I'm going to press N, and then I'm going to scroll up. And you see right here where it says mean crease 0. What we're going to do is use a shortcut, which is Shift E, and pull. However, I open this up so you can see that you can also adjust the mean crease here. I prefer to use Shift E, but basically what we're doing is we are moving this slider with the shortcut. So I'm going to press Shift E, and then I'm going to pull. And you see the mean crease rising as I pull. So once it gets to 1, it's 100%. And then when I go back to object mode, you can see now, you know, this stuff is much harder. Okay, and when you look at this, you might say, okay, well, it still looks soft right there, and then indeed it does. So what we need to do now is we need to click here and add a edge split modifier. And you can see with the edge split, it's a lot harder. So I'm going to click here, go to edit mode. Okay, and I was pointing to these, but we don't even have any mean creases on those yet. So what we're going to do is hold Alt, select here, hold Shift, select Alt there. And we're going to go to Edge Select. I'm going to take it off there. Press Shift E. Click here. And so you don't have to do it all the way. Like if you want it to be somewhat hard, I'm going to click here. And I'm actually going to take the mean crease down some. I'm going to click here, go back to object mode. And I click here, go back to edit mode. I'm going to take the crease off this right here. See how this looks? Holding the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to click here, go to object mode. Okay, so we're going to click here, go back to edit mode. Okay, what I'm going to do now is press A to deselect. I'm going to press A to select everything. A again to make sure that nothing's selected. I have edges and faces selected right here. I'm going to select edge there. I'm going to roll in. I'm going to hold Alt, hold Shift, select here. Select here. I'm going to temporarily turn off the subdivision surface by selecting this eye right here. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. That's the scale. I'll push this in somewhat there. Then I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in. I'll push straight down here. I'm going to press S to scale. Push this in a little bit more. Straight down. Push this in. And we're just trying to have, you know, some thickness right there. Press S. Whoops. I don't want that. Okay, I'm going to press A to deselect, A to select everything, and again to make sure that nothing's selected. Okay, what we're going to do now is roll the mouse wheel back, hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to hover here, press L. I am going to take the mean crease all the way up to 1, which it's really 100. Hold the middle mouse button to turn back. I'm going to hold Shift and the middle mouse button. By the way, if these lines that show your creases bother you, you can scroll down and see where it says mesh display. If you select creases, you know, they're still there, but you don't have to, you know, deal with looking at them. Okay, so we're going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hover here and press L. I'm going to hover here and press L for there, L for here. And I am going to scroll back up, and I am going to use the mean crease to take this all the way up. I'm going to click here to go back to object mode to take a look. And I need to turn on the subdivision surface back on. Okay, and we're gonna go back to edit mode. I'm actually gonna press A to deselect, press L here, and I'm gonna turn the mean crease all the way up. And we can always change our minds later on. I'm also going to I'm going to press A to deselect there. I'm going to hover here, press A, not L, not A, sorry. L, 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 L. I'm going to press Z, go to wireframe, select these different finger pieces here. Press Control, L. Look at that. I thought that would grab everything. I'm going to hold Shift and select here. Press Control, L. I'm going to hold Control, hold the right mouse button to grab that right there. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to turn to the side so I can grab this right here. I'm going to press Z, go back to solid view. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom back. I'm going to press S to scale. I left click the lock in. I'm going to take the manipulator and push this up some. And then I'm going to push this back some. Maybe S to scale a little bit more. Push this in a little. I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to click here, go to object mode to take a look. Okay, we're going to click here, go back into edit mode. I'm going to press N to take away the properties menu. I'm going to press Z to go to wireframe. I'm going to hold Control, hold the right mouse button. Select here. I'm going to press Shift E. Drag to the side to turn the mean crease up to 1. I'm going to press Z, go back to solid mode. I'm going to press Shift D, left click to lock in. And I push this over to the side. Okay, I'm going to press R to rotate on the Y axis, 90, then left click to lock in. I'm actually going to press N to bring up our properties panel. I'm going to scroll down to mesh display. I'm going to turn off creases for now, just because they feel a little bit distracting to me. So I'm going to press N to take away the properties menu. Okay, now I'm going to hold the middle mouse button just to take a look. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to press S to scale this down. Take the manipulator and push this forward. Just hold the middle mouse button to change the view. Rolling the mouse wheel to zoom in, holding shift and the middle mouse button to pan, hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to zoom in. I'm actually going to go to face select. I'm going to press A to deselect and select this face. I'm actually going to drag this out. Into the arm. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to hover L here, hover over here, press L to select that. I'm going to press H, zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and the middle mouse button and pan. Hold the middle mouse button to turn. I'm going to select one face here. I'm going to press shift D, left click to lock in. Then I'm going to pull this out a little. I'm going to press S to scale on the X axis. That's one of the cool things when you're working with robot things. You can just, you know, grab a piece somewhere. I mean, sometimes, I mean, you can do the same thing with organic things. It tends to work fairly decently with, you know, hard surface things. I'm going to press E to extrude, left click to lock in, pull straight this way. I'm going to press Control L, because when you have a piece of geometry selected and you press Control L, it selects the entire object. I'm going to press Shift E. Then I'm going to select this face again. Just pull this straight back. Then I'm going to press Alt H. Hold the middle mouse button to turn, and that's, for the most part, what I wanted. I'm gonna press A to deselect, press L, L, and L, and also L here, and just move this over a little bit. I'm gonna press A to deselect. Okay, what we're gonna do now is go to edge select. We're gonna hold Alt, select here, hold the middle mouse button to turn, hold Shift and Alt, select here. Then we're going to press Shift E, the hard crease right here, left click to lock in. Okay, we're going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom back. We're going to press A to deselect. We're going to press Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. Roll the mouse wheel back again, press Z, go to wireframe. You're going to hold Control, hold the right mouse button down. This lets you do a lasso select. You're going to select right here. We're going to press Z, go back to solid view. You're going to press P to bring up your separate menu. You're going to choose separate by selection. You're going to click here, go to object mode. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to select this object. It looks like it's two objects, but it's actually considered one object. You're going to press M to bring up your move to layer panel. Then you're going to select this third layer and click here. We're going to select our robot mode object here. We're going to press Shift D, and I'm just moving my mouse to the right. I didn't click anything or, you know, pull anything. Well, I pulled, I didn't, you know, click anything, so I can right click and it'll jump right back. And what I'm going to do with this is I am going to press M to bring up the move to layer, and I'm going to move this to the last layer up top. This one here that we have, I am going to apply the mirror modifier to it, so now this side actually quote unquote exists. Or we still have our duplicate of this object that still has the mirror modifier on it. So what I'm going to do is roll the mouse wheel to zoom back. I'm going to take the manipulator, pull this over some. I'm going to hold shift. I'm going to select the layer that has our plane on it. So there's our plane right there. I'm going to left click on this plane mode object. Okay, I'm going to click here to go into edit mode. I'm going to press A to deselect these parts here. Press A to select everything. I'm going to press Control 2 to put a subdivision surface modifier on that has a view of 2. I am then going to go here. You can see the subdivision surface modifier right here. I'm going to click this right here. I'm now going to press A to deselect. I'm going to roll the mouse wheel to zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and the mouse button to pan. You see these flat squares? That's because I did not put smooth shading on. So we're going to press A to reselect it. We're going to press Z, choose shade smooth. Now we're going to press A to deselect the object. We're going to hold L here and then hover here and press L. Hover here and press L. We're then going to press N. We could also use Shift E. I'm just choosing to go do the mean crease by taking this up here. So now we're going to click here, go back to object mode just to take a look, and you can see it's hard there, but it's not, it still has soft edges. If you can remember from before, we can deal with this by going to our modifier panel, clicking here, and selecting edge split, and now you can see we have our hard lines on this mesh again. When you adjust the mean creases and put a edge split modifier on your mesh, sometimes you won't like the look of it, so you might want it to be, you know, not turned all the way up. So one way to do that is you can hover your mouse right here, left click and hold, split your screen. We're going to press T to take away this panel because we're just going to use this to look at. We're going to click here and go to edit mode. And then for here, what we're going to do is we're going to press Shift Z. So we can use this menu here, or this window here, to watch what we do over here. So this is kind of a work window, and this is kind of a window to look and see what's going on. So now we can adjust our mean crease here. You can see it changed there. I want my edges hard, but not all the way up to 1. Okay, and I like that look right here for now of this. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this window away. I'm going to hover here. I'm going to left click, drag. See that arrow that popped up there? That arrow is telling you that the left window is going to overtake the right window. And now we're back to one window again. Okay, what we're going to do now is press N to take away this properties panel. We're going to click here, go to cycles. We're going to select the render button here. If you have if you had an NVIDIA card processor, you could click here and change the GPU. I believe now Radeon cards work also. I'm not totally sure. I'm pretty sure about that. We're going to scroll down here. I'm going to go to light paths. Change this max to 4. Change this minimum to 0. Seems like this helps to make cycles render a little bit faster. I'm going to click here, go to object mode. I'm going to zoom back. And the reason why we came in here is we're almost through this tutorial where we have our basic mode set up. We'll go into putting more detail on them most likely in another tutorial, as well as most likely there'll be another tutorial about texturing, and then there will be a tutorial about showing how to actually make this transform from plane mode to robot mode, And I would also like to do a tutorial where, you know, this is fully rigged, you know, in robot form. For now, we're just going to put some basic materials on. So I'm going to right-click right here. I'm going to press Shift-A. I'm going to bring a plane in. I'm going to press S to scale. Press S to scale more. S to scale more. I'm going to click here on this lamp. I'm going to press X to delete that lamp. I'm going to press Shift-A to bring another plane in. I'm going to zoom back, take my manipulator, and push this plane down. I'm going to press S to scale, S to scale, S to scale. There we go. If you're new to Blender and you're wondering why we came into a cycles mode, when you come into Blender, you start off in Blender internal. Blender internal renders very fast as far as actually outputting a image or outputting video from here, here being Blender. However, Cycles makes light look very realistic, and it just tends to make things look beautiful. However, with Cycles, depending on how fast your GPU is, things do tend to take longer, though. Also, in Cycles, I like to light things by planes. You can use lights and lamps in Cycles, but I tend to like to use planes just because it's fairly quick. I really like it as far as, you know, doing tutorials, just because my tutorials tend to be fairly long anyway, and it just speeds up the process a little bit. Okay, so what we're going to do is select this plane. We're going to hover our mouse here, roll your mouse wheel. You can also hold the mouse wheel and drag. I'm going to click here, select new. Where it says diffuse, I'm going to click there. I'm going to turn this to emission, and this will now put light out. This will allow the light to bounce back up. If we press Shift Z, we can see the results. When you see this green that's here, it's because your clarity of what you see is dependent upon your sample. So right now we have the sample set at 10. What we're going to do now is zoom in, hold shift, and you can see this number going up to 10, but we can click here and select sampling, and we'll go to render. Now this render button means when you actually click render to render an image or an animation, and this preview means what we're looking at right now. So we'll click here, we'll select 100, and then when you look here, you see that number racing up, and if you notice the image, as soon as I move now, it'll, you know, restart. But if you notice, as the image goes up, this looks clearer and clearer. And I mean, you can set the number up to, 1,000. I've seen people set it up to 20,000 before. I tend to use 100 because 100, you know, gives you fairly decent clarity of what you're looking at, but it's also fairly quickly. Our renders, our shows the preview, I guess I should say, fairly quickly. So I'm going to hover here, pull this to the side, and similar to what we did before, we'll use this to see what's actually going on, and we'll use this to work, and we're just going to quickly apply some materials to here. Okay, so what we're going to do is select our robot mode right here. We're going to click edit, go into here, and I'm going to hover here, press L. See, now we have to select both sides because this doesn't have the mirror modifier on it anymore. We'll select here. I'm going to hold shift and the mouse button to pan, zoom in here. We'll hover here and press L there, L here. L here, 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 also here. Here as well. Okay, so what we're going to do now is, now that we have these areas selected, is we're going to go to our materials panel. We're going to select this plus, the right plus here. We're going to select new here. Now we're going to go back to the plus that's to the right. Select here. select new again. Okay, and what we're going to do here is we're going to select diffuse. We're going to change this to a mix shader. A lot of times when people see me do it in here, they're like, the node editor is so much better. I agree with you. However, this tends to be, so it seems to me to be faster. So we're going to click here. We're going to go to glossy. We're going to click and change where it says GGX to Beckman. We're going to select shader here. And we're going to go to diffuse BSDF. Okay, so what we're going to do is this diffuse color will influence the color. The glossy will put a gloss over top of it. And then this factor will control how much of the color, comes in. So we're going to click here. Let's click fairly dark blue. And the reason why you don't see anything here yet, let me zoom in. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan, roll the mouse wheel to zoom in, is I have to click assign. So I'll select assign. And now you can see the colors, come in there. Okay, what we'll do now is zoom in. Holding shift, I meant to pan. Shift and the middle mouse button to pan. And what we're going to do is, so what we're going to do is hover here and press L. Zoom in a little bit more. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. Zoom in here. I'm going to press L. Now I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. The other hand, I'm going to press L as I hover. L. Okay, what we're going to do is with these same colors set up, we're just going to select assign. And that just added the color to the hands. Holding shift and middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to press shift Z again. Okay, I was just trying to, it's kind of hard to see if it was on there or not, but I can see that it's on there now. By on there, I mean the actual color. Okay, we're going to hold shift and hold the middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to press A to deselect. I'm going to press L while hovering over here. I'm going to scroll up. I'm going to select the plus to the right here. We're going to select new. We're going to go to diffuse. We're going to select mix shader. Okay, then we're going to click for shader, and we're going to select transparent. And then for the second shader, we'll select diffuse. I'm going to make this like a yellowish orange kind of color. We'll select assign. And then we have that there. We can control how transparent this is by the factor. We can also influence it by how dark our color of the transparent is as well. Okay, we're going to press A to deselect. I'm going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan. I'm going to zoom in here, hold shift and middle mouse button to pan again. We're going to roll that, hover your mouse here, select face. I rolled the mouse wheel to get this to move. You can also hold the middle mouse button and pull back and forth. I'm going to select here, hold shift, select here. Zoom in just to get the manipulator out of the way. Okay, what I'm going to do for here is go to this plus here again. I'm going to select new. I'm going to change this to emission. I'm going to select green, and then I'm going to select assign, and we can see that right there. Okay, we're gonna click here, go to object mode, zoom back, hold shift and middle mouse button to pan, select the plane object, click edit or object, and then select edit. We already have these areas selected here. Okay, and since our plane is essentially the same object, it should be the same color, so we'll click here, we'll select here, and I'm going to zoom back here just by rolling my mouse wheel. I'm going to press T to take away this panel right here. I'm going to press shift and hold the middle mouse button to pan to the side. Just letting go of the middle mouse button, still holding shift to pan to the side again. I'm going to hold the middle mouse button to rotate the view slightly. And that, when we applied that, because we had one material, it applied it, to the entire mesh, which is fine. We're going to click here. We're going to select here. Then we're going to select the plus here. And then we already have this color here. So what we'll do is select new, select here, and then choose this color right here, and then select assign. Pull this and drag. I'll zoom back so you can see what we have. So we have our basic, modeling down. We have our jet plane mode as well as our robot mode, and I will come back. The plan is anyway to come back later and add some more details into this. Show how to rig it so that this actually transforms from the jet into the plane. We'll also hopefully in another tutorial show how these arms and legs also need to be applied to the plane model there. Okay, I'm just going to hold shift and middle mouse button to pan a little. And okay guys, that's it for the tutorial. For all of those of you out there who like the videos on this channel and reshare them, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. If you guys definitely want to see those other tutorials on this, please let me know in the comment section. Also, I have a support button where you can donate to my channel. It allows me to have more time to make more videos. And for those of you guys out there who donated already, thank you greatly. I can't see exactly who donated, but I really, really appreciate it. And for those of you who are new to this channel, if you like the videos on this channel and you would like to see more, please subscribe, and thanks for viewing, guys.